Hello, good morning students.
Good morning, ma'am.
Yeah. Today we are going to learn how to develop creativity of our students, and that too through essay writing. Okay. So I had given you one activity that you have to write something about my friend. So you must have done some work. Okay. So can you read, Sonal, what you have written?
Yes, ma'am. I have so many friends, but Ankita is special. More than one friend, she is my soul sister. We met each other when we were in the first year of graduation. We shared many beautiful memories together.
Yeah, good. Then Winnie, can you read?
Yeah, ma'am. A friend is a person whom we could never lie to and say whatever our heart feels. And with them, we forget each and every sadness. A friend makes us smile at any situation, and we say them more than our parents or any person we trust. A friend is a guide and a person who never says us or gave wrong direction to us.
Okay. Salma, would you like?
Yes, ma'am. My friend is a person whom I feel more comfortable with. She is the one whom I can share everything. As we always say, a friend in need is a friend indeed. My friend is an apt example for this. She taught me to share every feelings and emotion. She taught me to smile and be happy always. And she is my strength throughout my life. And she is none other than my mother. And she is always my best friend.
Okay. Swati, have you written? Yeah.
Yes, ma'am. In everybody's life, there will be a friend whom they share, talk, love, fight, love. In my life, I'm also blessed with one good friend who is always part of my life. Though we don't get time to meet often, we still know each other's moment, daily activities. We just enjoy being each other.
Okay. So you all have written, and I think if we just analyze all your responses, it seems that some characteristics are common to everybody's response, right? For example, sharing feelings, sharing thoughts with each other, then friend makes us smile, makes us happy. So all these things are very common. So the same thing happens with our students. Of course, these are very important characteristics of friend, good friend, right? But still, if our students write the same kind of essays, then how they are giving their creativity, how they will be able to express themselves in different ways. So for that, we are going to learn some new technique, we can say, or a new model. But we are going to experience it first. And in the same way, you are going to implement it in your classes. So should we go ahead? So now, we are going to learn a new technique through which we are going to develop creativity of our students. So what is that technique? We are going to make them aware that they can use analogies. Do you know analogies?
Yes, ma'am. Yes, analogy is usage of some other example in place of another.
I will give you one more example. Robert Frost is a poet. It's a long poem, but I'm going to mention only a few lines of it. The poem is like this. Two roads diverged in a wood. Two roads diverged in a wood, and I had to choose only one. Then he says something about each road, etc. We are not going to learn all those lines. But in the end, he says, I took the one less traveled by. I took the one less traveled by, and that has made all the difference. Now, this particular poem and analogy of that roads in the jungle, we can make it to explain the life and work of Baba Amte. Can you find out the similarity? He took the road less traveled by. That means nobody else used that road. Now, has somebody understood? Can you explain me how he has taken a different road? Yes, Gunjan?
Become a politician to do social work. Rather, he took his own decision and took a road less traveled.
Now, you all have written something about your friend, essay. But now we'll see how different analogies can be used. And that's why I have brought here some visuals. Some are living objects, some are non-living objects, some are even machines. But still, we have to see how you can find similarity, how you can join two different things together. That means our friend, his characteristics, and characteristics of some of these objects. So joining two different things together. That is this technique. So let's see one by one. Okay? Now what you have to do, you have to see one object of this picture and then find out characteristics of that particular object and then fit it with characteristics of our friend. Maybe the friend is your real friend or something in your imagination. Doesn't matter because we have to write essay anyway, isn't it? So we'll start one by one. Yes, first visual is of a computer. So can somebody find out similarities between characteristics of computer and our friend?
As computer stores information, in that similar way our friends also stores our memories, good times that we have spent with each other.
Okay, so we saw how computer can have similarities with our friend. Now let's see one by one some other analogies. Now about the book, who is willing to tell similarities? Yes?
You can read book with my friend. Whenever we feel low, we go to our friend to share information, to relieve from stress. So whenever acts like a stress buster, we read books to relieve stress.
Yes, you correct. Now coming to ant. Yes?
Many ants. So my friend is also like an ant. She is very hardworking. And when we are working in a team, it is very good. The work, which is very good.
Yes, very good. Now about the tree. Yes, Avani.
I can relate my friend with a banyan tree because a banyan tree have strong roots. Likewise, my friend is very strong and supportive to me.
Now in the end, syringe. Yes.
I can relate my friend with injection. Whenever I feel low, I talk to her and I feel good. She might scold me, it might hurt me, but at the end what she advises, it is for my good.
Okay, very good. Okay. So we have seen how different objects, living or non-living, can be related to the topic under consideration. That is my friend. But this particular finding similarity, it was direct analogy and just superficially you compared both the things. But we have to write essay and it should be unique. And that's why we have to go one step further. And that is personal analogy. That means all the objects that we have seen, we have to go into the role of that particular object. Like stepping into shoes, we can say. I'll give you one example and then you can also relate or use that personal analogy for other objects. All right. Say, for example, syringe. If a syringe starts speaking, what will it say? The syringe might say, I am a syringe and I hurt people. I'm also writing some keywords over here, and we are going to make use of those words afterwards. Yeah. So what will the syringe say? The syringe will say that I hurt people. I prick. And that's why people are scared in the beginning. They hate me. But it is for their good, right? It is beneficial because once I inject medicine by hurting people, they are cured. And in the end, once the people are cured, then they don't blame me. Then they are happy and actually they thank me. Because of this injection, I got cured. So this will be personal analogy. So you have to now go into the role of each object and try to explain what will the object say. So accordingly, we have to do the exercise with a few of the objects.
I am a balance. I try to bring fairness in life. I don't get carried away by emotions. I might take away the load, but my aim in life is to bring fairness.
I am lion and I bravely handle the responsibilities and I took decision bravely and I will, I'm responsible for the whole animals in the forest and I'm not ready to compromise. I have my own principles.
So now, through our discussion, we have got many words. Now, the third step of it, of this particular model, is finding out compressed conflict. That means finding out if the words which are conflicting, which are opposite of each other, but together if we use, then they add meaning to it. I'll give you another example and then you have to find some such conflicts, compressed conflicts in this list. Say, for example, there is an old person, but he's very youthful. He's very enthusiastic and works hard, just like youth. So we can say youthful old person. So that is compressed conflict. In the same way, healing knife. Usually knife hurts, it cuts. But healing, a surgeon's knife is healing knife. So now you have got the idea of compressed conflict. So just observe all these words and try to find pair of such words which are conflicting but will go together and add meaning to our essay.
Beneficial prick.
Happy sacrifice.
Responsible hurt.
Living machine.
Tiring selfless service.
So now you have got many ideas. We have used many analogies, but you can think of more also. Not that only these seven objects you have to compare your friend with. You can think of any other living object, non-living object, but do the same thing with it. First, find out the characteristics of that particular object, and then try to relate it with our friend's characteristics. Go into personal analogy, go into that role if you want to think more. And besides that, try to write down all the keywords and use those compressed conflicts as we have done now. So now it's up to you. I'll give you some time. Think about different analogies and try to write a good essay on my friend. And for that, suppose you are using analogy of syringe. You have given me that it is beneficial hurt or something. But at that time, you have to think about some incidents. You have to describe one imaginary incidents in which probably you were hurt in the beginning, but then you thought that her advice was very beneficial. So some such incidents you have to create and write the essay. And same thing you have to do with all other objects. So now it's your job. Start writing. So all of you have written essay, right? So you must have come up with nice ideas and nice expressions about my friend. I hope you have used the compressed conflicts that you suggested in our session. I have written it for you. Okay, so who will be the first? Amrita?
I'll read. A friend is a word synonymous to fun, sharing, love, happiness, care, guide, perfect partner, and an inspiration. One can compare your friend to the best of things on earth. Yet to narrate an incident which is bittersweet to me, I will compare my friend to a syringe. I had just passed my 12th with flying colors in math, and although I loved English, I scored only 60% in the subject. I was thoroughly demoralized. I wanted to become a journalist. Like the road most traveled, I opted for good engineering colleges. I was filled with confusing feeling. Happiness, sadness got the better of me. Happiness because I will start my new life, and sadness because this is not what I really wanted. So I turned to my crazy guide, my best friend. Having learned that I am joining those obnoxious good colleges, she shouted at me. She was angry because I was a dream killer and that I was breaking my own dreams. Her words stung me like a needle. Feeling guiltily happy that there was still someone to support me in my decisions, I carried on and joined a media school. Today, I am a renowned journalist. I now realize my friend was like a syringe. Her words stung like that of a syringe, but like an injection, her intent and the injection's content got me back on track.
Very nice. Yeah. Come on, Vinnie. You may start now. Very nice. So now you have that experience of using analogy, going into personal analogy, and how to create compressed conflict and use it in the essay. The same technique you have to apply for teaching your students and developing their creativity. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.